Well, howdy. My name's Billy Clem Bob Delmont, and I'm the guest cook on the Cooking with John show. Today, we's gonna make some butter beans and bacon and some cornbread. These vittles are gonna be so good. The first thing we gotta do is cut us up an onion. So here's an onion that I already peeled off a skin. Maybe a half is good enough. Let's leave it at a half, I think. We'll put the rest of this in the ice box. Now we're gonna put that aside because I gotta cut up one more thing. Put these here in this bowl here. Now I'm gonna cut up a little bit of one of these here banana peppers. You know why they call them banana peppers? Don't that look like a banana? I think that's why they call them that, because they sure don't taste like bananas. So we gonna cut up some of this. I'm gonna put them in the bowl with the onions. So they just sitting together in the same bowl. You don't have to dirty up a lot of bowls when you're doing this. You just dirty a couple of them. Besides, old Blue, he don't like licking the onion bowl. Now, the very next thing we gotta do is we gotta cook up some bacon. We're gonna cook it up in this here cast iron skillet. Because when you make cornbread, that's the best thing to use, a cast iron skillet. You can put that right in the oven. So we're gonna put it in this here cast iron skillet, because we're gonna use cast iron skillet for the cornbread too. So once you get this here cooked bacon cooked up in this here skillet, it'll have grease in it so the cornbread don't stick. You don't want the cornbread to stick. I gotta get this here. These are some very skinny slices. I've never seen bacon that skinny before. I'm gonna have to cook up a bunch of it because that's just not enough there. Gonna need at least a couple more slices. So that'll work good. It's gonna be good. You're gonna love this. So we're gonna get this bacon all situated in the pan, put it on the burner so it can commence the cooking. I love these here newfangled stoves. They start by themselves. This here bacon's just starting to cook. It sure do smell good. I love bacon. We got to get us a mixing bowl. Now I'm gonna make cornbread out of this here Jiffy Corn Muffin Mix. It's America's favorite. Right up there on top, so you know it's gotta be good. But I don't got no milk right now. The cow done run dry. But I do got me a chicken egg. They's the best. You don't want to use none of them dang doll seagull eggs. That stuff will kill you. Tastes like fish. I think that bacon needs a stir. That bacon's almost done, but there's a couple pieces over there that need to get a little more crispier. Now we gonna be mixing that bacon with these here butter beans. Tarnation, that's gonna be good stuff. Well, this here bacon's done. Okay, I'm gonna put this here bacon into this here for a minute. Then we gonna scoop out some of this here bacon grease. And then we'll go get us a pot holder so that we can grab this here skillet. We gotta give it a tip and put some of that there bacon juice in here. And then we're gonna put in our onions and our peppers. We're gonna cook them up a little bit. You wanna pre-cook them some so as when they go in the cornbread, they be already cooked. And they're gonna taste a little bit like bacon. Now, we're going to take our pre-cooked onions and banana peppers and put them in this same bowl with the bacon for a minute. But we're not gonna mix them up. You don't want to mix them up. We're going to use this pan again. Now we gotta mix up our cornbread. So first of all, we want to put this here Jiffy corn mix, cornbread mix, into the bowl. Open it with your fingers. There we go. Open the bag up like that and dump it in. Now we gotta open up this here cream style corn. I like cream style corn. It's good. I can't make my own cream corn because I don't know how to do it, and I ain't got no cream anyways. I do like corn on the cob, but I can't eat it anymore, so I use the frozen corn. Besides, I don't need the corn cobs no more. I got me a JCPenney catalog. I just popped one of my suspenders. I hope that stays on good when I goes to swimming, because these things hold up my swimming trunks real good. That before I had these, I was glad I was by myself. All right, I found me a can opener and we can commence to opening the can. All right then, we're gonna take some of this corn and we're gonna put it in there with the cornbread mix. We need to put the chicken egg in there. So I'm gonna do that first. Get this here chicken egg in there. And then, got chicken egg on my hands. Mix this up a little bit. And we gotta put in, I think we're gonna need more than a third cup with this corn. So I'm gonna put more corn in it. Like that, maybe 2/3 of a cup. 1/3 and 1/3 is 2/3. I learned that in school. So I'm gonna mix that up. Oh, we won't put this stuff back in there now. We'll put these things in, the onions and the banana peppers into the cornbread mix. That's gonna be good. We might need a little bit of some milk, but like I said, I ain't got no milk. So I'm gonna put some of this here powdered milk in it. I don't know how much is a third cup. I'm just gonna throw some in. And I might have to add a little water, I don't know. Let's see how that works. Mix that through. Yeah, we need a little bit of water. Put some of that in there. Push that around some. That looks good. We're gonna put our oven on 400 degrees. And we're gonna put that in here. But first of all, we want the batter to sit for 3 to 4 minutes. I'm gonna dribble a little bit of this here bacon juice back in. I'm gonna push it around like that. And I push it up the sides too. This should be good. Pretty soon it's gonna be time to put together our butter beans. Now while we're waiting for the oven to get hot, I'm gonna cut up this bacon, and that batter's still gotta kinda sit for a minute. So we're gonna cut this bacon up so it can go into the butter beans. Now that's ready. Don't need this here no more. Oops. We're gonna put our butter beans in. We're also gonna pour us a little bit of this here bacon juice in them beans. Just a little. Here's our butter beans and bacon, ready to go on the stove. Don't that look good? Now we're gonna commence to warming up our butter beans and bacon. It's time to get our cornbread into the pan. So let's get the pan over here. It's still kind of hot. Put that there, and we're gonna pour this here batter into the pan. We're gonna stir it lightly, just a little bit, and then commence pouring it right there into the pan. We're gonna get it all now. Can you see me? Bet you can't. I'm hiding behind this here ball. Okay, here we go. That's gotta go in for 20 minutes. Right now, the big hen's a little bit after the 12. So we gotta wait till it's a little bit after the 4, and then it'll be done. So each one of those numbers is 5 minutes. So you goes 5, 10, 15, 20. I learned that in school. Well, since we got some time to kill, why don't you go to a commercial?
Tank all night, wreck the car, get you iron jail bars. Well, you better call Midtown Bail Bonds. Wife and kid alone at home, helps a waiting on the phone. Mike and Butch at Midtown Bail Bonds. It don't matter who you are, time of day, near or far, there's someone to post your bail at Midtown Bail Bonds. 440-245-3688. Call them up and don't you wait, Midtown Bail Bonds. Midtown Bail Bonds.
Oatmeal King, get yourself some oatmeal.
It's Cooking with John.
Let's have a little peek at the cornbread. Oh, it's looking good. Vittles is almost ready. I can't wait. I'm hungry. While that stuff's cooking, let's have a hillbilly word of the day. It's always good to increase your vocabulary. Now, let's see, what time is it? The big hand is a little bit past the forward. That means it's ready to come out. Ooh-wee! I'm gonna put it in just for a couple minutes. It don't look quite done. I'm gonna give it a few more minutes, maybe 5 more. That means the hand will be a little bit after the 5. Okay, that cornbread's done now. Oh boy, you just take a look at this here. You see that? Look at that nice toasty look on it. It's so good. Okay, we gotta cut some up. I think we're probably gonna have to let it cool down just a little bit. Oh, who am I fooling? I'm gonna cut it all the way in half first. But I'm not gonna eat half. Then I'm gonna cut out a pie wedge. Now you know what? They say pie around cornbread are square. Not this one. This here cornbread round two. So, pie and cornbread are round sometimes. You make sure you handle this pan with a pot holder because it done been come out of the oven just now. So, okay, we got to get it under there a little better. Let me see if I can pry this up with the knife and get under there with the pancake flipper. And pull it out like this. Oh, look at that. That looks so good. Nice. Got the butter, beans, and bacon. Here it comes. I'm just going to put this all on my plate. Yeah. Time to eat some vittles. Now there's one more thing we got to do to make this all good. We got to put on some butter. Real butter too. You don't use that margarine chicken killer stuff. So put some butter on them butter beans, because that's why they call them butter beans. And then you gotta put some butter on this here cornbread too. Now you just look at that and tell me that ain't good. Butter beans and bacon and cornbread. Oh boy, time to eat. Some of this here beans and bacon. Ooh, wait, that's good. That's so delicious. And I'm gonna try some of this here cornbread. It's got the cream corn and the onions and the banana peppers in it. Dang, that's delicious. I'll tell you what. Oh, it's so moist and it's sweet. And it's corny too. Got that corn flavor in there, it's so good. And it's so fluffy. You gotta eat it like cake. But here's some of the crust too. I like the crust. It's perfect too. Look how good it come out. That's so good. Then it go perfect with these butter beans and bacon. Well, there it is. Butter beans and bacon and cornbread. So good. You better try this. I know you're going to like it. Well, that's it for this show. This is your buddy, Billy Clem Bob Delmont. And I want you to like and subscribe on this one and share it around with some peoples. And y'all make some of these riddles. You're going to love them so good. All right, bye. Butter beans and bacon. And cornbread. I'll get me some more cornbread. Where did that thing go? Maybe I will eat half of this.